Good afternoon, brothers and sisters, and welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. We will now have the Feast of Our Lady of the Rosary. Please all stand.
Let us now listen and watch the live broadcast of the Feast Day of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, po.
Good afternoon, Bishop.
Today is a very special day because we honor our Mother, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. But before going farther, I would like to ask you to greet the people around you, good afternoon. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Altogether, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, fill our hearts with your love, and as you revealed to us by an angel the coming of your Son in human form, so lead us through his suffering and death to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Sing and rejoice, O daughter Zion. See, I am coming to dwell among you, says the Lord. Many nations shall join themselves to the Lord on that day, and they shall be his people, and he will dwell among you, and you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will possess Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and he will again choose Jerusalem. Silence all mankind in the presence of the Lord, for he steers forth from his holy dwelling. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Remembered his promise of mercy.
The
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had ascended to heaven, the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olives near Jerusalem, a mere Sabbath's journey away. Entering the city, they went to the upstairs room where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon, the Zealot party member, and Judas, son of James. Together, they devoted themselves to constant prayer. There were some women in their company, and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word."
And the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please remain standing.
Please be seated.
Sa ngalan po ng mga obispo dito, Bishop Vic Bendico, the Bishop of Baguio, Bishop Bobby Gregorio, Bishop of Batanes, and Bishop Rick Bakay, the Bishop of Alaminos. And all those who have come here today, we would like to thank Father Provincial, Father Napoleon Sipala Jr., Father Anthony Yudela, our prior, Father Alan Lopez, our parish priest, and all the Dominicans who are here. Thank you so much for inviting us for the celebration of the feast of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. Palakpakan natin sila. Pwede pong magtanong. Hello. Pwedeng magtanong. Okay. Were you here last year on the celebration of the Feast of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag? Sino po yung nag-attend last year? Bakit nandito kayo ngayon? But you know, I would like to go into the name. Sa Tagalog po, it is tawag. Sa Pangasinan, tawag din. Sa Ilocano, it is awag. And the meaning is call. And that is why we have the name Manaoag. Let us go into that one. The call. Alam niyo po, sa aking batch, we were 36 when we started the seminary. And we ended, tatlo lang po ang nagpare. Sabi po nila, yung tatlo may bukasyon. Yung 33, walang bukasyon. Pero later on, hindi pala ganun. All of us are called. Niapu Dios ti mga awag kada tayo. Iti tunggal maysa no anya iti daytay estado na. And that is why if all of us are cold, then we ask ourselves, what then? If you are called to be a father of the family, then you are asked, to be the best father in your family. That is your calling. If you are called to be a madre, that is your calling. Be the best madre in town. If you are a priest, that is your calling. Then be the best priest in the parish. Kaya po dapat ganun na hindi lang po yung mga pare ay may bukasyon. All of us. If you have been called to be a lawyer, then be the best lawyer that you could be. Ay, oo nga pala. Congratulations po sa UST. Kalalabas lang po yung results ng bar exams. Madaming UST graduates who entered the Magic 10. Congratulations, UST. If you are a farmer, a merchant, a pedicab driver, as much as possible, be the best that you can be in your own line. Kaya po, intindihin natin yun. What do you think of the Blessed Virgin Mary? She was called to become the mother of Jesus, and this Jesus will not only be born, but will be criticized, will be tortured, will suffer death, but yet he will rise again on the third day. The Blessed Virgin Mary, if you try to see the readings, that even if Jesus rose from the dead and went to heaven, the Blessed Virgin Mary was in the company of the disciples, praying, doing what Jesus taught them to accomplish. Manawag, tumatawag sa atin. And if you try to see the second, the Blessed Virgin Mary is called Our Lady of the Rosary. But actually, the Rosary is just part of it. Because wherever the Blessed Virgin Mary appeared, she was asking, first of all, for conversion. Conversion. It is a 180 degrees turnaround, not 360. It's 180, but actually conversion means change of heart. So that in the prophet Isaiah, the Lord was saying, I will give them a heart of flesh. I will take out that stony heart. Ibig sabihin, stony heart, unforgiving heart, without mercy, without compassion. Conversion, that was what the Blessed Virgin Mary was asking wherever she appeared. Second, she was asking for penance. Kasi po, it seems that sin is no longer here with us because everybody is doing it. Penance, it's not what you hear when the priest says, pray five times the Our Father. Hindi po sapat. Penance. What do you give to your friend who became your enemy? What do you do with somebody who hurt you? What do you do with somebody who is poor, who is in need? Penance, visit the sick, feed the hungry, clothe the naked, visit those who are in prison. And the third, the Blessed Virgin Mary was asking for prayers. And we say here, especially the Rosary. And that is why our shrine is called Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. It's not simply mumbling words. Kung minsan naghahabulan, hindi pa tapos yung isa, then if you cannot finish the Rosary, well and good. Do not be afraid. Ay, hindi ko natapos ang Rosary ko, nakatulog ako. So what? But you know what is important is the Rosary is not simply reciting the prayers. It is meditating on the mysteries. If one decade will take you 5 minutes, so be it. Hang kayo nga aglulumba, nga agrosaryo. No, that is not the idea. Because the Rosary is a meditative prayer. You try to meditate on the mysteries so that in the end, after you have prayed the Rosary, there is an effect on you. And that is why I was asking those who came last year for this celebration, nandito na naman tayo, was there a difference? May epekto ba sa buhay mo, you're coming to celebrate the Feast of the Lady, or wala? That's it. That is the challenge. And that is why beautifully placed, the title of this minor basilica is The Shrine of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. Jesus is calling us through the Blessed Virgin Mary to pray the Rosary so that the Rosary changes us, changes our relationship, changes our pananaw, changes the way we behave and live. Okay ba yun? Hello? Okay ba yun? Tama na.
Please all stand.
With the prayer of the Blessed Virgin Mary as our model, let us give praise to God and present our needs.
For every intention we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of the Church, may they look up to Mary as their mother and live as worthy children of so noble a mother. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For national leaders, may they strive to further justice, peace, and the common good of the citizenry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the abandoned, may they feel in their sufferings and needs the protection and maternal presence of the Virgin Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who devoutly recite the Rosary, may they be drawn closer to God through this prayer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who celebrate the feast of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, may we, like Mary, praise God, recognize His might and mercy, and remain faithful to Him until death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us include our own intentions and the intentions of this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, You sent Your Son to be born of a woman, Mary. Grant that our devotion to her may draw us closer to Your Son, who lives with You and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you. Let us all pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice today may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O Lord, by your forgiving love and by the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, may this offering bring us prosperity and peace, both now and forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, as we celebrate the patronage of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, she became the Virgin Mother of your only Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is forever the light of the world. Through him, the choirs of angels and all the powers of heaven praise and worship your glory. May our voices blend with theirs as we join in their unending hymn. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Socrates, our Bishop, Elmer, Assistant Bishop, our Bishop Constance here, and all the clergy, religious, and your entire people.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, thank you. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
You are listening and watching the live coverage of the Feast of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. And the celebrant for this feast day is Most Reverend Jacinto A. Jose D.D., concelebrated with the Dominican Fathers.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Lord our God, in this Eucharist, we have proclaimed the death and resurrection of Christ. As we ponder these same mysteries in the Rosary, help us to proclaim them to your people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
Born of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Son of God redeemed the human race. May he enrich you with his blessings. You received the author of life through Mary. May you always rejoice in her loving care.
Amen.
You have come to rejoice at Mary's feast. May you be filled with the joy of the Spirit and the gifts of eternal life.
Amen.
I would like to ask my brother bishops to bless the congregation. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.